up is Jose with Greylock for Java developers. Welcome, Jose.
Thank you for coming. Well, this talk is I will try to introduce you to Greylock. What is Greylock for monitoring and showing metrics for from our applications, and we will see also how to integrate these metrics with our applications in a classical Java project with Maven and other and some libraries. This is the agenda. This is the main points I will see. I will make an introduction to Greylock and how we can install this the environment for using Docker image and Docker compose. Later I will comment the main Greylock architecture, what are the components of the Greylock. And in the last 2 points, I will show how we can connect with Java and other services like Elasticsearch, Logstash, and so on. Well, what is Greylock? Greylock is one of the main open source log management system tools that we have in the open source ecosystem. It's like it shows many ways in shows the metrics. It has a user interface for showing the metrics of our applications, and the documentation is very good for installing and introducing this kind of systems. What are the main features? Greylock is the, as I recommend, is an open source log monitor system capable of handling messages from different main sources. We can connect with application servers like WebSphere, WebLogic, DevOps. We can connect also with Java AE applications, Node.js, Python, C#, and also we can use the Greylock monitoring system with web servers like Nginx or Apache. We have many options to connect with Greylock. For installing this tool, we have many options. The classical package for Debian, Ubuntu, Red Hat, or CentOS package. We have also the option for using virtual machines. We have open virtual appliance image. We can use with VirtualBox. We can also the background option for installing this system. And we can also integrate with config management system like Check, Puppet, or Ansible. And the best option for me, the most simple for starting using this system, is installing the Docker, and we have Docker image, a specific Docker image from the Greylock for installing in a very easy way. In less than 5 minutes, we have installed all the configuration. And also we can use Docker Compose for installing the containers and the image for installing this system. Well, the option that I've commented before for using Greylock with virtual machines, we have the URL, we have open virtual appliance. That is an image for using in VirtualBox. And in a nice way we can also configure this system. And for me, the best option for me is and the more easy way is using Docker image. In the Docker Hub we have the minimas, the minimas for Greylock. Basically with making Docker pull from this image, we have with a little configuration, changing one IP address or some lines, we have installed the system. These are the, for example, if we want to launch in with Docker, we need first launch a Mongo container in the first, and the second we need a Elasticsearch, because rather than we comment architecture, but Greylock needs for running MongoDB and Elasticsearch, these two services. We run a Mongo, Elasticsearch, and in the third command we launch the Greylock image linking with the Mongo and Elasticsearch. In this way we can communicate the Greylock containers with the Mongo and Elasticsearch containers with the link flag. We have also an easy way. You can use Docker Compose with one only file, one only YAML configuration file. We can install, we can deploy the Greylock environment with that. This is a classical configuration YAML file that we can see that we define the Mongo, Elasticsearch, and Greylock services. And in the Greylock services, we define also environment variables like the password secret for the Greylock, the endpoint URL, and we define that this Greylock depends on Mongo and Elasticsearch. And we define the ports where Greylock is listening the events of the application. For persisting data, in Greylock, the best configuration is use Docker volumes for storing information in Mongo and Elasticsearch. And in this way, we define Docker volumes for persisting this information. This is an example of execution that we can see that we see the Docker volume configuration in the first script capture, and in the second script capture you can see that we have the three images, the three containers executing is one in an independent way. We have the Mongo service, the Elasticsearch service, and Greylock service. In Greylock service, for example, is listening in the ports TCP and UDP. These ports, we will use these ports for communicate level with our application in Java. Well, the main Greylock features. Greylock provides receives mass messages for multiple input protocols via HTTP, UDP, TCP, Syslog, Apache Kafka. An interesting feature is that we can assign, when we receive a message in the Greylock, we can also make a specific filter over this message with the streams. Later we will see an example how we can manage the strings, and provides basically stores messages in Elasticsearch for graphing and MongoDB for storing metadata and alerts. An interesting feature also is that provides search and graphing capabilities for stored messages. From a graphical point of view, these are the options that provide Greylock. We have strings that are a way of filter message, of grouping message in categories, grouping the message that we receive, alerts, dashboards, searches, and security for managing users and permissions. These are some script captures we can analyze and search the message that we receive for another application of service. We have alerts, triggers, metrics, user management, and we can connect from various inputs and outputs. From TCP, UDP. We can connect also with RabbitMQ and Apache Kafka, for example. We have plugins for connecting with this kind of service. The main storage that has Greylock is Elasticsearch. All information, all messages are stored in an Elasticsearch indexes. And basically, we have a storage for storing this information. This is a script and tool for where we can see the configuration for Elasticsearch indexes. And as I commented before, we have for starting working with Greylock, what we have to define first is define the inputs. The inputs basically are the channels for communicating with Greylock from the other application or service. For example, if we want to send a message by a TCP protocol or UDP, we have to define an input where we define the port, the what is listening, and the address, the IP address, what is listening the service, basically. An interesting feature that I commented before is the streams. The streams is a way of filter the message that receives the Greylock interface. We can filter in real time when we are working in real time with other application. In real time, we can filter that message. That message that we receive in real time, we can filter information with conditions that we can define. We can define also alerts for sending notifications, defining criteria, and analyze and configure these alerts. This is the main screen for extracting stream. We have an easy screen configuration for editing the rules, manage the outputs, alerts, and start the stream. This is the script tool that provides Greylock for defining when we create a stream rule. When we create a stream, the first we have to do is creating a rule. A rule basically is a condition by, for example, we want to filter by a specific field or property. We define a rule for this kind of message. Depending what is the information that we want to filter, we need to define different rules. We have different many rules for the same streams and filter in this stream filter information by many conditions depending what are the things that we need. For filter this information, Greylock, for example, use internally is for filter in the stream message is using these Java classes that are matches that basically are the classes that is using Greylock internally for extracting the information using regular expressions, pattern matching, and this kind of information. This is another script tool for Greylock. We can define the alerts configuration from a string. commenting now the Greylock architecture. The Greylock architecture, the main Greylock, we have a basic Greylock architecture. We have the Greylock server for processing all messages from many resources. We have also Elasticsearch cluster, can be one machine or many machines. We can define a Elasticsearch cluster, and in the MongoDB we can use also one machine for the MongoDB, or we can also have replicas, MongoDB replicas for within a cluster of Mongo. The classical configuration, the most easy configuration that we can do with Greylock is have one Elasticsearch node for storing all the information related with messages, the MongoDB that stores the user and the configuration, basically metadata and also this configuration, and the Greylock server that provides a RESTPA for communication we have the Greylock server and the Greylock web interface. The Greylock web interface is the web interface that we have seen before, and the Greylock server communicates with the web interface through a REST API. And for communication for receiving messages from devices or service or other applications, it has many ways of message inputs. We can go more configuration with configuring a cluster. We can have a Greylock cluster of servers, we can have a Elasticsearch cluster, and we can have a MongoDB replica set. And in this way we have the main difference with the previous version is that in this case we have a load balancer. The load balancer, what it does is distribute the different requests that the system receives, and it tries to distribute the requests between all the Greylock servers that we have in our architecture. Well, how we can connect with Java? With Java, basically we have the first of all is that for sending log data to Greylock we have many ways. We have the classical syslog, we can use XCP, UDP, AMQP, Kafka, the GELF, that this is the option that we are going to see in details, and we have other options like collector or sending the information in raw or plain text. The option that we are going to see now is the GELF. The GELF is the Greylock extended log format that use Greylock for storing the metadata associated with the message that the server receives. Well, the GELF is the acronym of Greylock Extended Log Format. Basically, we can use it's a format very standard in the log ecosystem. It's very useful to use it with Logstash, UMD, Docker, and this format is based in syslog and rsyslog, but it provides a better performance, a better configuration, a more usable configuration. Basically, it's a JSON-based format for sending structured data. The main problem that we have with syslog is that syslog it has limitations related with the message length, the connection timeout or connection problems, and GELF try to solve these problems adding structure, adding metadata to the message that the platform receives. Basically, is when we are communicating, this is the main for the main structure for we have working with GELF document. Basically, we have a JSON document for where we put all the fields that our system, our application is monitoring. We can monitor the timestamp, host, the server. We can send also short and full messages, the level of the log, and some environment variables that in a specific moment with our application can need to communicate with for showing the metrics, for example. In this example, we can see this is a discrete capture of Greylog that in Greylog we have the message inspector where we can see that this kind of a structure. We have a full message, and the level, and the shows, a timestamp. This is a message that we have sent from an external application. Well, for starting with logging in Java, we have, if we go back in the time, we have the classical log4j for logging saving in Java. We have also the simple logging pipeline for Java. These are the projects the first project that are very useful in Java. And these libraries are very useful for logging and register metrics of our application. Also we have another project, another interesting project. This is the LOPAC project. This is a project based in Log4j project, but this project what provides is a faster implementation of Log4j and a performance 10 faster than Log4j. And with this library, we can, in a very easy way, we can connect Greylog with our application with them. Basically, these are the jars that we have. We can obtain these jars with Maven, for example. Basically, we can connect with Greylog with the GELF4j and the LogPack. Yeah, these are the last version of the libraries that we can find in Maven repositories, for example. Basically, the GELF4j is an implementation in Java and Log4j appended without any dependence. We can find this project, this library in project and integrate in a easy way with a classical project in Java E with Maven Artifactory. If we try to go in details in the JAR, we can see this configuration. We have the log package that we have the appenders and the class for checking the connection with the Greylog server, and in the main package we have classes related with the senders. These are the classes for sending the information to Greylock server. Depending what is the protocol, if we see the classes, we have senders for UDP, we have senders for TCP, and we have senders for AMQP. Depending what is the protocol that we have. Another configuration that we can do is configure the Get Appender. The Get Appender provides is the main configuration that we can to use for connecting with Greylock. We defining the Greylock host, the port, the level of the book, the book level that we want, and so on. In a very easy way, we can create a class. This can be a Greylock interface where we define an init sender, depending what is the protocol we want to use. We can use UDP, TCP, or the other. We can also have the sell get message for what is the, this is the method for sending the message to the Greylock server. And the send message where we define the, for example, the a message with title, a title and a description. And what the information that in this moment our application is the value, for example. This is the configuration that we can do in a classical Java project. For example, if we're using Spring, we can create a Spring bin for injecting in an easy way the server and the port and the book level. And in the main application, we obtain the bin with the context, application context class, and we use the method that we have seen before, send message, or for sending the message to the Greylock server. And in an easy way, we can send the message that in a specific moment or in a specific use case, our application is monitoring. Another option that we have is using the logpack. The logpack is compatible with GDK, equals or major 1.7. Basically, we have to add the following dependence to our project. In this case, we are defining the Maven dependency. And as before, the library is the same, but in a different package, we can use the same classes for sending messages. We can also configure the logback appender for sending, for example, this configuration. This is another example that we can use for connecting with Greylock with a REST interface using the REST templates. This is another way of connecting with Greylock via HTTP input. We can also connect with other services like Elasticsearch, Lostas, and Kibana. For connecting, for example, with Elasticsearch, we can use RabbitMQ, the message broker RabbitMQ. And in Greylock Marketplace, we have a lot of plugins for connecting with other services. We can connect with AMQP protocol for sending syslog messages to Greylock, and also we can connect with Apache Kafka. Apache Kafka is a public distributed public system subscribe for sending messages, configuring topics, and so on. And that's all. These are the references, basically the official documentation and the repositories where we can find all configuration and the source code of this project. And that's all. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much. So we took the whole half an hour for the talk, so there's no Q&A, but I guess we'll be around if you have any questions, talk to him directly. So thank you.